bisschen dunkler auf hellbar.
Nee, nee, das ist klar, das ist mir logischer. Aber ich denke, das ist vielleicht nachher nicht so einfach.
29, I think, is deleted. Sorry. 41.
Must have gone at the weekend.
Oh yeah.
Because that's been deleted for years. Yeah. Actually, it's easier. We just go for doubles, don't we?
Yeah, it's a double. And then we had two copies of one stage.
They're just not available now, but you could try Jim Asmund's down the road.
Yeah.
He may just have a copy second hand of some of them.
Across the road?
Just down the road, down the road, about a 2 minute walk. But otherwise, that's the only way you'll get them at the moment is second hand.
Second hand.
Yep.
Right.
Now, if you write to Steve Lane at VJM Records, he might put them on tape for him, but he does do tapes of out-of-print material from the masters. So if he wants to write to Steve Lane, you've got his address.
Yeah.
I think he does. He has supplied us with tapes in the past of deleted things. So.
Good. Okay.
But anyway, is try Jim Asmund's down the road.
Around this same street.
No, if you go out of here, you turn left, then turn right. Mm-hmm. Carry straight down past the traffic lights, and you come to St Martin's Lane. Mm-hmm. On the other side of the road, the first street is New Row, and Jim Asmund's shop is down there.
About very
well. Take you about 5 minutes to walk.
Okay.
It's just possible he may have an odd copy there. You know.
Man. travel. Mad.
It's all I'm afraid, so could you put the cap on? Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
going to meet him there. Eddie.
What?
I'm sorry, go ahead. Sorry.
Thank you very much.
Dreams in Minder, tomorrow at 9 on 10.
£84 a week. 89. And the family lose all the benefits.
Hiya. Bye.
You take that job then?
Aye, £89 a week. Cup of tea, please, love.
What? You're going to be worse off than you are now, man.
Well, I'm not going to get up at that time in the morning for a few extra quid a week, like.
Still get me benefits, only different ones.
Now, a cup of tea and watch the world go by, as you put it.
Well, that's your life.
If you're unemployed, getting a job needn't mean losing out on benefits. Get the booklet from your unemployment benefit office or job centre.
I'm thinking about the sand on the beach. That's really soft.
They're trying to describe a totally new kind of softness.
It's like snow and marshmallows. I think it feels like a squashy bun.
It comes from a totally new kind of fabric conditioner.
It's nice to hug things.
Mine is a bit cuddly.
It's lovely.
Introducing new Lenore in original or summer fresh. It's almost too soft for words.
John Dryden wrote, "Where passion rules, how weak does reason prove?" You'll see. Bee to the blossom, moth to the flame, each to his passion, what's in a name? Depends on the name. Shakespeare from Julius Caesar. Passion, I see, is catching. Sure hope so.
Elizabeth Taylor's passion, exclusively at Selfridges.
Could there be a better way to feed the dog you care for? Top breeders say there is.
One of our dogs had a delicate time. He wasn't very happy on any of the foods that I'd been trying.
Now there's a new way. New Pedigree Chum.
With New Pedigree Chum, he's blossomed forth into a really good-looking dog, and now he's a...
When I write a cheque, there's just a few quid over my balance. I don't want sarky letters. I want it cashed.
You want a free overdraft?
Sure I do.
Interest on your current account?
Right.
What about the bank charges?
Nope, none of that.
You pay a fixed monthly fee?
Yeah.
Well, my darling, this must be your lucky day.
Pissy. I was looking forward to getting my hands on that bank manager.
Vector from Midland. A new kind of bank account for a new kind of customer.
It's 10 o'clock.
Nurses' pay, the mood's friendlier, talks next week. The young senator, Mr. Bush, has picked as his running mate. Mr. Nelson Mandela has TB. His wife wants a second opinion. British Rail tells intercity travellers your tickets are too cheap. And do calculators help or hinder with maths? Good evening. The government suggested tonight that there could be more money for the nurses. Management and unions in the regrading dispute got together again this evening for the first time since the nurses walked out of the talks last week. Both sides say they're one step nearer agreement. The mood has changed. They'll meet again next week. The Health Minister, Mrs. Edwina Curry, said...
I've got four girls, so I have four times as much dirty washing to do.
You should see the state of them when they come home from school. Absolutely filthy.
So we asked Sue, who's always used Daz, to try new Daz.
Well, I didn't think I'd say this, because I'm very happy with my old Daz. But this new Daz is definitely better. These socks were absolutely filthy. Covered with muddy lines from the skipping rope. Even the old Daz would have got them out, but now they're brilliant.
So, Sue, will you swap new Daz for your old Daz?
No chance. If it gets their clothes white, I'm sticking to it.
New Daz. It's even tougher on dirt or even whiter whites.
Honey, nuts, and brown sugar.
Watch out. The Halifax Personal Pension Service. It could well be your best plan.
Go on, ask a few of your
trick psychological question. I have nothing to hide.
Nothing to hide?
Hello, Webby. What's it? Oh, no. Oh, guys, I need your
blood. Come here, baby. You can clean up your own mess, because I'm fed up being made the scapegoat.
Scapegoat, you moron.
Don't like wearing dresses.
How can anybody possibly be a doctor and a human being?
Dr. Sweet certainly can't. Medical disorder in rude health this Friday at 10 on 4.
Now on 4, pathos, pyromania and politics of volatile mixture in St. Elsewhere.
Touches our lives in quite the same way as electricity. No other form of energy brings us so much enjoyment. Electricity. Energy for life.
Bush has just two reports published today on maths and science teaching. The maths report said long division was no longer necessary.
This is how maths used to be taught and still are taught in a few schools. No calculators. Instead, tables learnt by heart and recited aloud. And lots of long sums painstakingly worked out on paper, if not on slates. This is how most children do their maths now, calculators at the ready. Mrs. Thatcher and many on the right would prefer the traditional method of learning by heart. These two reports published today represent two of the government's core subjects. The maths report is damning about the state of the subject. On standards, it says, it remains a matter of concern that the decline recorded for England and Wales is greater than for any comparable country. On the connection with the country's economy, it is becoming more and more important for economic survival to raise standards of mathematics attainment. But it's the report's support for calculators which is highly controversial. The report says it's absurd to pretend calculators don't exist, and further they claim it's unnecessary to teach pencil and paper techniques for long division and long multiplication. The government want to see more emphasis on the basic principles of maths.
But what I want is secure.
But it's giving Americans nightmares. 35 days now, the temperature in New York and many other places has been hitting the mid-90s every day, sometimes dropping to a cooling 91 or so, sometimes reaching into the hundreds.
You'll see temperatures in the 80s and 90s all across the country, and again climbing into the 100s.
Well, it's hot, humid, miserable, sticky, muggy, it's everything you don't want to be around.
To stand all that, you need the stamina of a horse. No, that wouldn't be enough.
Look at it, it can't stand up!
She's talking about one of New York's famous carriage horses, which fainted from the heat while pulling some tourists around. After lying in the street for an hour and being hosed down by vets, it was able to stand up, leaning against a car for support. The subjugating heat has sent all who can scuttling for the water. In Chicago, office workers skipping their jobs to head for Lake Michigan.
It is unbearable. I can't believe it. I mean, it is just so hot. We just had to come here.
But there was little relief even here. The usually chilly waters were almost bubbling, over 80 degrees. No end in sight. Ken Reese, News at 10, in America.
Yes, Mr. George Bush's fault. That's it tonight. Good night.
Tonight at 11:35, Outland with Sean Connery.
I'm not trying to prove anything. That stuff they're selling is killing me.
It's an amphetamine. Strongest thing you ever saw.
What are you at?
Good evening. Detective Sale bomb planted by animal rights activists on the car in Maidenhead could have caused death if it had gone off. The device, packed with high explosives, was placed beneath a Mercedes owned by the managing director of Costain Construction. Costain were recently awarded a contract to build experimental laboratories for the chemical giant Glaxo Pharmaceuticals. Paul Garton.
Bomb in Maidenhead town centre came in a phone call to a local newspaper.
In a steady, serious voice, the caller said, "Don't interrupt me, but listen carefully and take notes. In the Broadway multi-storey car park, there is a bomb. It has been placed by the Animal Defence League against Costain Construction. It is due to go off at 9:30 a.m.
Stories of the day. Chancellor Nigel Lawson may need to reverse this year's tax cuts in the 1989 budget, according to the influential Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development. In a report published today, the OECD warns that the British economy is in danger of overheating, and the price could be soaring inflation. Rupert Seeger reports.
The warnings from the OECD, a Paris-based think tank supported by the so-called Rich Man's Club of 24 leading industrialized nations, comes in its annual report on the British economy. And though it says the UK's performance compares favourably with that of most other member countries, there are major concerns for the future. The rapidly expanding economy is on the brink of overheating.
Dollars in June, compared to just under $9.8 billion in May. The resumed negotiations between leaders of the nursing unions and the health service adjourned tonight, with both sides saying the talks have been constructive. They agreed to keep in close touch, and more negotiations are due to be held next week. Cleveland Social Services Director Mike Bishop says he'll stay and fight accusations made in a highly critical report on his role in the child abuse crisis. His colleagues once again threatened to take industrial action if disciplinary measures were brought against Mr. Bond, two of the busiest weekends at the end of the summer. The action is certain to bring more chaos to holiday flights, which are already affected by routine delays caused by overcrowding of the European skies. In Pakistan, Western diplomatic sources say that the main Soviet ammunition dump in Afghanistan has been blown up by guerrillas. The explosion is believed to have caused heavy Soviet casualties at the base in Kalagay. A new national newspaper arrives on the streets tomorrow morning that's sure to renew the controversy about standards of taste and decency in Britain's tabloid press. The Sport, as it's called, is the stablemate of Sunday Sport. And they're both backed by David Sullivan, who's made his fortune by publishing a range of soft porn magazines. To begin with, The Sport will appear once a week. If it's successful, it'll go daily within 6 months. And so, how successful is Sullivan's recipe for combining maximum female nakedness with minimum journalism likely to be? Janet Truin reports on the birth of The Sport and the state of the troublesome tabloid family which it joined.
Sport's first morning news meeting in its Manchester headquarters.
We have discovered someone who has escaped from the lizard man of Brown Town, this creature that lives in a lake and gobbles up local residents. We've now got
a thrusting group of experienced tabloid hacks seek the formula that will see off the competition.
And we've had our supply of fundoms, which we will be giving away and spreading the word about AIDS. Prize for whoever thinks have the best competition, and how we choose the winner as well.
Ask what kind of paper they want it to be, and they say, like The Star, when it linked up with Sunday Sport last year and went unashamedly down market. That is, until the advertisers pulled out in embarrassment. Could it be a sign of things to come that the Press Council has already upheld a complaint against the topless ad published to launch the sport? One boob they could have done without. The news team, poring over the first dummy issue, is undaunted.
We aim to provide a newspaper which comes under the market that already is there. I believe that the Sun and the Mirror have already got that market sewn up. So the only way to compete with them on the counter is to find a market which is under them. There is no harm in being the paper which has again found true value in raciness, raunchiness, big pictures, a bit of fun, people say sexy.
The notorious Sunday Sport is the inspiration for the new paper. Sex, science fiction, and more recently the freakish and absurd has gained it a reputation as the worst kind of sleaze paper. Critics accuse it of every crime known to journalism. Nonetheless, it's economically successful. Its profits are paying for the launch of the sport, and its circulation after only 2 years is close on 500,000. The man behind it all is soft porn publisher David Sullivan. He's proud to say he's learnt a thing or two about newspapers since he went into the business.
Right back, all it has to do is... Okay. You can do it any...
inside, it doesn't matter. You're going to fly in a circle anyway. Just make sure you don't hit anybody. Make sure you don't fly
off.
And catch them. Three planes per
platform. Yeah.
Wing down, flaps down, and tail down.
Now we need to go.
devices to save our planet. Challenger Control will now display certain alien targets as obtained by our counterintelligence forces.
Я хотела сюда капот, я здесь на фоне, да. Я думала, без света есть, я тут пойду. Ты же папа,
thank you.
You mean like me?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Patel, traveling to Paris, please contact the Air France desk in this lounge. Mr. Patel, to contact the Air France desk in this lounge, please.
Aquí vengo.
Prendió. Bueno, pues aquí desde Luxemburgo lluvioso, un saludo para todos los montevideanos,
en especial para mi familia,
para la abuela Blanca, en especial para la abuela Blanca.
Y a tu papá y a tu mamá.
Y a mi papá.
Y a mis hermanos.
Y a mi hermana. Y a mi sobrina.
Ay, no, 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 parece mentira que te tenga que estar. Que te tengo que estar.
Sin decir nada.
Diciendo lo que tenés que decir, me parece horrible, Gabriela, por favor. No me saques a Enrique.
La estrella era ella,
¿no? No me saques a Enrique, que ella es la que tiene que salir.
Nada más, ¿no? ¿Qué hay que decir más?
Piensa.
Y al
gordo,
venga,
Gaby,
firma
el
gordito.
Al gordo y a Sara. Miralo, cómo se ríe. Sacale el chupete, sacale el chupete.
Ahora sí, así.
Que nadie lo conoce todavía, ni siquiera de fotos.
Hombre, el peinado napoleónico.
Pobrecito, que es el lujo de la mamá.
Mano rápida, mira, mira ya.
El único bueno de la familia.
Mira, fue la tele, hijo mío, es la tele.
Estamos muy bien, Javi. Enrique, estamos muy bien en compañía de ustedes. Ha sido un placer tenerlos aquí estos días, aunque nos han molestado bastante de noche con los ronquidos.
Firma a mi hijo con el no, no, no. Decirle que diga no, no, no. A ver. No, no, no.
Estoy comiendo todavía.
No, no, no. No ve señora que viene la gente.
Hasta las 2:30 tienen tiempo.
Wow. Es esta gente viendo como a mí que se me han hecho
bueno.
Bueno, Henry. Gabriela, mandá
decir algo importante.
El trabajo
Carmen que diga algo para Manolo.
No, no, no.
Para Manolo, no, porque se pone.
Mira, Guille. Nada, que de eso estoy muy bien estupendamente. Ya nos veremos a fines de año, de este no, del año que viene. Iremos a pasar las vacaciones millonarias, si Dios quiere, Dios mediante, los cuatro. Vale, ya nada más. ¿No?
Y que estás muy bien, que te sentís
muy bien. Estoy estupendamente bien.
Que te vean la cara, si no.
A ver, Guillita, ven aquí, que te... No, tan cerca, no, que se ve de todo.
No, sácale lengua.
No, no,
una sonrisa agradable.
Mamá, ¿verdad? ¿Verdad que la mamá tiene muchos compañeros de trabajo?
Sí, la mamá está muy bien relacionada en el ambiente masculino, sobre todo, ¿no? para desgracia del marido.
Y además se han inflado pescado aquí en el Parlamento. Se han inflado. Y a vino.
Dijiste, para desgracia mía, mi marido está celoso, de mis compañeros.
Ah, sí, eso sí, por supuesto. El médico también.
También.
El médico sobre todo.
Bueno, Carmen, saludos a Manolo.
Y una vieja.
Y a Carmen.
Se está tratando
ya,
mal.
Ya,
mal.
Tomando
vino.
Se está maltratando acá con un vino del Mosela estupendo.
Sí. Bueno, ¿y qué le tenés que decir a Marta?
Que no, le mande, nada, que le mande falta yerba, que extraña mucho el matecito.
Para que la pueda firmar bien. Ribaner.
Este, sí. Ajá. Es una desgracia, malísimo.
Bueno,
el ambiente.
No, de chocolate casi queda poquito también.
Sí, bueno, ahí está, yo lo voy a llevar.
Currucucu.
Oye. Yo no tengo nada.
Se acabó el pasito.
Yo no tengo plata.
Asustina con la
bucana. No importa. Las peleas. Se estaba sacando las peleas.
Está sacando las peleas.
Hoy es
19/8/88.
A las 14:21, hora Luxemburgo.
O sea,
Luxemburgo, ciudad, comunidad económica europea.
Seca. Parlamento Europeo.
Déjale la boca
ahí.
Está Enrique.
El TAC. Estamos en el TAC.
Estamos en el BAC.
Ah, BAC.
¿BAC?
Thank you.